astonished that we're on the eve of the closure of the Cuisle Centre, the Irish Wheelchair Cuisle Centre in Dunamin. And it's a very sad situation. And basically it's a case, I don't know, we don't know, they don't know, and we don't care. Two ministers, according to the IWA, were contacted, and my colleague Deputy Nocton was contacted and did make reps, I know that. Was the other minister, Minister McGrath? Minister McGrath told the Shannon yesterday he was never lobbied by the IWA. It's amazing where the government gave 39.4 million to the IWA that they're not able to stretch a point here to give the 1.1 million for this particular venture to continue. All, as Deputy Nocton said, we're asking the government to make them pause this situation. And I have to make this final point. There was a powerful demonstration across party at the Health Committee last Thursday. One of the most powerful groups that spoke, one of the most powerful people that spoke was Deputy Kate, your own deputy, who has been in the news this morning, Kate O'Connell. But it was a cross-party, 12 people. Okay. And the IWA CEO has refused, as Deputy Nocton has said, to give any reply. That she said she would go back to the board, she said she would put it to the board, and now she will not even respond to the members. Please, Minister, get this pause now. It is causing untold hurt and damage to vulnerable people. Please.
I also met a parent of somebody who accesses these services and has done regularly over the last number of years, and she made a similar plea to what some of the deputies are saying this evening, or sorry, this afternoon. The issue, as I understand it, is that the IWA have proposed that they would move from providing services in this facility to locating services in accessible hotels in both the Galway area and the Midlands as an alternative to what Cuisle is currently providing. I think the government is open to talking to the IWA. Certainly Minister McGrath has indicated that he's available to meet at any point with the IWA or the HSE on this issue. But I think we also have to be guided by the organisation that are actually providing the services to try to provide the best services they can for their clients. I also understand that there is a significant capital investment requirement at the Cuisle facility of between 1 and 2 million euros to make it compliant in terms of standards and safety and so on. But I will speak to Deputy McGrath, or to Mr. McGrath, in relation to the issue and try to reflect the concern that's been expressed.
The next three.